always privileged to introduce not only really a world-renowned expert in myeloma, but also a really good friend of mine for many years, Dr. Saad Usmani. He's the chief of the myeloma service, and he's going to talk to us a little bit about when myeloma comes back. Unfortunately, as we've said, this is a disease where we've made huge progress, but the disease typically does come back. But this is an area with tremendous excitement of all sorts of new things that are happening. So I don't want to take any more time from you, brother. So Saad, I'm going to turn it to you, and I really look forward to hearing your thoughts on when myeloma comes back. The floor is yours.
Thank you so much, Joe and Yelak and, Robin, everyone, for being here and for inviting me to be part of this program and really kick off our efforts to disseminate knowledge and create this wonderful platform for our patients. We can move to the next slide. And next slide, please. I think, Dr. McHale has already done a wonderful job in kind of setting the stage and sharing why it's, important for us to talk about multiple myeloma and how, as the population in the U.S. is getting older, the number of patients being diagnosed with this disease is going up. So I'm not going to, belabor that point. The beautiful thing that he shared is, the number of, people who are passing away from this disease has steadily gone down. The people living with the disease for, 10 plus years, even 15, 20 plus years, continues to go up. And that is, really remarkable to see. And at every step of the way, we try to find the best strategy for our patients, whether, it's the time of diagnosis or if the myeloma comes back. And I'm going to try to share some of that, our thoughts on how we think about, how we approach taking care of our patients, when that happens. If you go to the next slide. Next slide, please. Yes. So, the reality, of our healthcare system is access remains an issue. This is something that we have recognized for many years and now are actually doing efforts to circumvent this. We know that Blacks have twofold higher incidence of dying from multiple myeloma compared to whites. And historically, the access to therapies was an issue. But new studies have actually shown that when patients, Black patients, do get the same access to care, they actually have a better survival outcome. They live longer. And they have better responses to therapies. And this is, we're seeing this with older therapies. We're also seeing this with newer therapies. So this is a very important point to make and to spread the word and to highlight the fact that early access to treatments, to, utilization of stem cell transplant when it's appropriate, all of those things are important in caring for our patients. Next slide, please. So, this slide, I've actually used this slide for several years with minor modifications, maybe for the first 4 or 5 years, but then, we keep on increasing, the survival of our myeloma patients, and that is truly remarkable. Myeloma is not one disease. We know that, when patients go from this, pre-cancer condition called MGUS or MUGUS, as the great Dr. Kyle says it, we are seeing patients at different time points. So patients may have different amounts of myeloma or different kind of effects of myeloma by the time we're seeing them. And that makes, this process, decision-making, management quite dynamic, and teamwork is required. We understand what's happening inside the myeloma cells and inside the bone marrow where these cells live much better. And we are trying to pick that right strategy for patients. And this is a very good time to be a myeloma researcher or doctor because of the advances that are coming down the pike. If we go to the next slide, I think, this is the general approach that we have typically taken for our myeloma patients. There will not be a quiz on this slide, I promise you. And this slide is only supposed to, highlight our general approach. And the idea for this frontline general approach is get our patients to a good response and maintain them there. The tools with which we are doing that now are different than what they will be in the future, because we have some very exciting immune therapies that are in clinical trials, some that are already approved for more advanced patients. We're going to be able to utilize them hopefully in the future at the time when people are diagnosed. Dr. McHale has already, eloquently stated what, how we manage patients early on. But the thing that I'm going to talk about a bit is, when the myeloma comes back, when the disease relapses. So if we go to the next slide, I want to highlight that, it's not a one-point decision-making that happens in myeloma. We gather information when people are diagnosed. We have a team discussion because there are many different kind of doctors and teams that are involved in taking care of patients. We may have to talk to the kidney doctors, the radiation doctors, the orthopedic surgeons in certain instances, someone has an area of the bone that needs to be, repaired or stabilized. We then develop this treatment plan and try to implement it. But things go according to plan. Sometimes, things don't go according to plan. So you revise your treatment plan, you take care of, what's happening to the patients, and then, you do that data gathering. So it's a very dynamic process, and the patient and the caregiver is at the center of all of this. Because after all, you guys are the, main characters of this movie, and we are just the supporting cast. Next slide. And, we have many different options. And again, they are coming down the pike. This slide is not supposed to be, a quiz for anyone. I'm just highlighting the fact that we have so many different drug classes that are coming to the rescue of our patients when the myeloma comes back. Given the fact that myeloma tends to occur, typically in the older age, these are therapies that most of our patients actually tolerate well in clinical trials. They're very effective. When I started in the field, at that time there were only two boxes on this slide, and we were just getting excited about that third proteasome inhibitor box. And now we're seeing all these different mechanisms of actions. This is really an exciting time to make this progress for our patients. Next slide, please. And there is no quiz on this slide either. The basic message from this slide is we try to tailor treatments to our patients. We pick therapies based on how patients are presenting, what kind of disease features they may have, and patients also bring their own baggage of health issues. So once we pick those strategies, and if the myeloma comes back, you can imagine, different patients have received different therapies for different durations of time, and that makes the decision making quite an interesting process. And the way that we frame this, if we go to the next slide, we try to look at factors that are patient specific. Then we look at factors that are disease specific, and also, from a treatment standpoint, what kind of therapies patients have received, what kind of responses that they have, do they have any lingering side effects from prior treatments? As the myeloma is coming back, are there any aggressive features to it that require special attention or special kind of, treatment approach for patients? And then as our patients grow older, they also, get other health issues along the way. So we pay attention to that as well, when we're thinking about selecting treatments for our patients. If we can go to the next slide, please. And, you know, this is actually the research arm of the International Myeloma Foundation, which is the International Myeloma Working Group, which Dr. McHale and I are a part of. And we've developed algorithms to make sure that we are delivering the right treatments to the right patients. You know, that this is the, you know, function of, you know, the wonderful success we've had in the field. We have many different options for our patients when the myeloma comes back. And we try to, you know, look at prior therapy exposure, you know, other health issues in deciding, you know, what kind of treatments patients may get. And many times, you know, we are recommending a clinical trial participation for our patients, even when the myeloma comes back for the first time, because with some of the therapies that we have right now, they might actually be, you know, potentially better options, you know, to go on a clinical trial rather than, you know, the standard of care treatments. So, you know, so we have those discussions. I think, you know, I give the example of, you know, what one of my patients, you know, used to tell me, a very, you know, staunch, you know, patient advocate as well, that, you know, if there would ever be a cure for myeloma, doc, the, you know, I want to be that first patient on a clinical trial to get that cure. So the point, you know, the patient was trying to make is, you know, if we are going to find a cure, you know, the people who will be cured first are the ones who went on a clinical trial. And that actually paves the way for many patients in the future. The therapies you see, you know, on this slide, you know, there were patients, you know, who went on clinical studies to, you know, get these therapies approved for patients across the world. So, you know, kudos to them. I think it's an, you know, very important part of what we try to, you know, educate our patients. Next slide, please. All right, I think that was my last slide, Joe. With that message, and I was just going to give a shout out to, you know, our myeloma service team colleagues, as well as the transplant cellular therapy team on the next slide. And I will hand things back to you, my friend.